Hello children, this is a story titled Ollie the Otter. So if you're all sitting nice and comfortable, then I'll begin. Ollie the Otter was swimming around, as usual, in a small lake where he lived way out in the middle of a big forest. Ollie Otter had been collecting small twigs and branches from fallen down trees with which to build a small dam in the adjoining small stream. Ollie Otter would make his dam, then it would rain, the dam would bust, and then Ollie Otter would start all over again rebuilding his dam. This was Ollie the Otter's job. Apart from swimming around in the lake, looking for bits of wood and twigs with which to build his dam with, and also catching fish, which he liked to eat, especially salmon, which was Ollie's favourite fish dinner. Ollie Otter loved it where he lived and had many friends who visited the lake all day long. One evening, Ollie Otter decided he had had enough of collecting twigs and just swam into the middle of the lake under the water, as he often liked to do. Ollie Otter, after having enjoyed his swim and a few fish he happened to eat on the way, decided it was time for him to go to his nest and have a rest, as night was drawing on. On the way back over the lake to where Ollie Otter had his nest, Ollie noticed a foggy mist coming through the forest towards the lake, just as it normally did as evening drew on. As Ollie Otter approached the bank of the lake, he was met by Rubel, the water rat. "Had a good day, Ollie?" Rubel Rat asked. "Just the usual, Rubel. Now I feel very tired. I've had enough of collecting twigs, and I'm going to bed," Ollie Otter replied. Just at that moment, Moni Mouse popped up out of her hole nearby. "Have you seen Moppy the Mole lately?" Moni Mouse asked. "Not me, Moni. You, Rubel?" Ollie Otter said, turning to look at Rubel the Rat. "I haven't seen him either," Rubel Rat replied. "Well, if either of you happen to see Moppy Mole, tell him he has bored a tunnel right through my nest here and down to the water's edge. And when it rained this morning, I was flooded out. So I was. Now my home is like a swimming pool," Moni Mouse said, quite exhausted. "Well, you must be lucky, Moni. Wish I had a swimming pool next to my nest," Ollie Otter said, laughing. "Yes, perhaps. That's a good idea, Ollie. Could do with one myself. I must speak with Moppy Mole. Perhaps he can dig one out for me," Rubel Rat said, joining in with the laughter. "Ha, ha, ha. Very funny. Well, I'm not used to the water, not like you two are. So if you want a swimming pool, you can both have my one, as I have had to build a new nest now," Moni Mouse said, as he quickly disappeared down her hole once again. Just at that moment, Spotty the Starling flew down to have a last drink of water before bedtime. Then Hopsy the Hare came by as well. And then Bertie the Blackbird hopped over and took a drink of water. And what seemed like out of nowhere appeared Hairy the Hedgehog. Then lots of other small animals appeared and all came for a drink of water from the lake and to talk to each other, as they did every evening. It was soon getting dark, and after a short while everybody said good night and left to go to their homes in the forest. Ollie Otter was soon fast asleep in his nest. The very next day, Ollie Otter was awoken by a strange smell coming from what seemed like the other side of the lake to where his nest was built. Ollie Otter, his eyes now wide open, saw the mist laying on the water over the lake. It was like a very thick fog. It was so thick, Ollie Otter could not see the trees on the other side of the lake. "That smells something terrible," Ollie Otter said to himself. In fact, it was not a fog at all, but smoke that had drifted over the fields and through the trees in the night and now lay on the lake. The fields behind the forest were on fire. Ollie Otter had never smelt smoke before and could not make out what this terrible smell was. A lot of other animals suddenly came running through the forest, which surrounded the small lake, all running in different directions. Dolly the deer came running over to where Ollie Otter was standing. Hopsy the hare just popped out of his hole to see what all the confusion was and quickly disappeared down it again. All different types of birds flew out of the trees and landed down by the lake, walked around a bit, sipped some water, then all flew off again. Even Furry the fox came down to the lake and ran away after a while as well. All different kinds of animals were fleeing the forest and the smelly old smoke. Ollie Otter was quite shocked at so many birds and animals all running like crazy in every different direction. Then Ollie Otter saw the flames eating away at the bushes and the small trees as it got nearer and nearer to the small forest. Ollie Otter had never seen flames before in his life and just sat by his nest looking at them. Dolly the deer came racing over to where Ollie Otter was sitting and looking. "Quick, Ollie, we have to get away from here," Dolly deer said, quite alarmed. "Whatever for, Dolly? What is going on?" Ollie Otter asked. "The forest will soon be on fire," Dolly replied. "On fire? What is fire then?" Ollie Otter asked. "It's all those flames over there in the distance, and it eats everything in its path. Even you if you're not careful," Dolly deer replied. "I'm not afraid. Nobody's going to eat me," Ollie Otter said. "But the flames are very hot, and the smoke is very thick. Just the smell is bad enough," Dolly said. "Well, I can swim under the water. Perhaps the fire cannot swim in water. And look, the smoke is afraid of the water. It's only laying on top of the water," Ollie Otter said. "Well, perhaps the fire is afraid of the water. You will find out anyway if you stay here, Ollie. I've got to go now, so I hope you come through all of this all right." "See you later then," Dolly deer said, as he suddenly skipped and hopped away over the fields. Just at that moment, Ollie Otter heard a strange noise in the distance. The noise got louder and louder and louder as it came nearer to where he was standing. Then suddenly, out of what seemed nowhere, appeared a big red lorry, and it stopped right at the edge of the lake, not far from where Ollie Otter was standing and just looking. A lot of men jumped down from the big red lorry and started to unwind a long rubber hose from the rear of the lorry. One end of the hose was laid in the lake, which was attached to a machine, which was in fact a water pump, which after a while pumped water through the hose, which shot out of the other end of the hose with a terrific force. The men aimed the water up into the trees of the forest on the other side of the small lake. Then another big red lorry appeared, then another and another, until there must have been what seemed like lots of men and big red lorries all parked alongside of the lake. Ollie the Otter just stood there and watched as everything was going on. Ollie Otter decided to swim over the lake to get a better look at what fire was and to see if fire had a mouth to eat with. The fire was burning and eating its way through the forest very quickly. And as Ollie Otter reached the far bank, he walked slowly onto the bank and felt the sudden heat from the flames. All the trees close to the lake were on fire and being slowly eaten up by the flames. Suddenly, a branch that was burning with bright orange and yellow flames fell down into the lake near to where Ollie Otter was standing. The water put out the flames very quickly. "So the fire does not like the water. I guess if I stay in the water, the flames cannot eat me then," Ollie Otter said to himself. The men worked all night and into the next day and eventually put the fire out with the water from the hoses by the next morning. Ollie Otter had been swimming most of the night around the lake and was quite tired. But all of the branches and even some trees that had fallen into the lake were put out by the water. But there was still the terrible smell and a lot of smoke everywhere, which Ollie Otter did not like at all. A few weeks later, everything was a little better. It had rained a few times and the terrible smell had slowly died away. All of Ollie the Otter's friends came by to visit, and Ollie told them the story of the big red lorries and of all the men running about, and how the water was not afraid of the fire and had helped put the fire out. "You were very brave to have stayed here while the forest was being eaten by the flames, Ollie," Dolly Deer said. "Oh, Dolly, I just stayed in the water, and the water was very brave, and the fire got eaten up by the water," Ollie Otter said quite proudly. So Ollie Otter, who had never seen fire before, now knew that if it happened to come his way again, the water would always save him. So children, we hope you've enjoyed our story about Ollie the Otter. And now it's time to say goodbye, and we hope you'll listen to our Ollie the Otter song. Goodbye, till next time.